Welcome to the Phantom Xtraordinaire. This is no ordinary show. Here, some of Nigeria's boldest and most extraordinary people will grace our screens and spill their secrets. They are some of the best in their industries, visionaries and pioneers, charting new courses that many have followed and continue to follow. Now join us as they tell their truths and choose their dreams. It will be inspiring. It will be daring. It will have you in your feels and at the edge of your seat. It will be fun. Come, let's go on this bold ride together. Welcome to today's episode of the Phantom Xtraordinaire called Bold by Design. Here with me on the show today, we have a pioneer of many firsts. In the year 1999, she started the first bridal directory. And in the year 2000, she held the first series of bridal seminars. Now, moved to year 2004, she opened the first makeup studio in the country. Fast forward to the year 2005, she released her own line of beauty products and opened the first makeup school here in the country. Now, in 2014, she held the first makeup conference nationwide. Join me as I welcome one of Forbes' top 50 most influential women in Africa. Guess who? Tara Durotoye. Mommy T.
Who is your mommy?
Auntie T. Tara.
This is how people turn somebody into an old person. Stop it.
You're looking young as ever. You and your husband, you guys have cracked the code of looking young and aging gracefully. You look amazing.
Thank you, Tobi. Lovely to see you. Lovely to see you again.
You didn't say anything about my clothes.
Sorry, you have just been... You're just too hot.
I saved this one for your interview.
I can see that it matches even what I'm wearing.
Yes, I'm nice to be talking to you. I have so many questions to ask you. I've been reading through your bio, reading through your achievements. One thing they should also call you is Mrs. First.
First to do,
and you're still doing.
I will collect that, that one. Yes. Okay. I'll create a badge.
I'll keep it first. I'll get it for you. So, what has it been like achievements upon achievements, and you're still going for it? Mm. What is your drive?
Well, it's purpose. That's my drive. Purpose meaning what was I created for? Why am I here on this earth? And I think every single person is born with purpose. And we have to, if we want to live a fulfilling life, we need to know what our purpose is. And with your purpose, then you don't feel like you are overdoing, you don't feel drained, you can keep going on. So I look at 23 years of running my business, right? And many of the first that you've talked about, many times when I did those things, I did them because there was meaning to it. I felt like lives were being impacted, and that's the center of who I am, impact, empowerment. And so when I'm doing, it's because I'm empowering, and that fuels me to even do more. So the more I empower, the more I feel empowered to empower.
Hey, the more I empower, the more I feel empowered to empower. And I read one thing. Mama, you have chest too. You have mind. Your father sent you to school to go and read law. You do your chest like this. That's no. You want to be painting. You know, let me just talk like that. You want to be painting face. How did you survive in that house? Because imagine back in the day, you're expecting your
lawyer.
And yes. She says she wants to paint face. And that industry was non-existent at the time.
Absolutely. But you know what? When we talk about chest, I'm not even get chest. So there was no chest to have, right? Because I was young. Okay. And I think that sometimes when you're young, you're not afraid. Now there's a lot of pressure on young people. But when I was growing up, when I was in university, it was just, if you wanted to do something, you go ahead and do it. And to a large extent, there wasn't a fear of failure because I was in school. So I was actually going to graduate and go and practice law. I think what made me lucky was the fact that before I graduated, I had now created a name for myself that made it easier for me to now start that profession. But while I was in school, somebody would say, were you afraid? Not really, because there was nothing to be afraid of. Like, you just do it, it's fun, you do makeup for your friends, it's nice. And I didn't even have the aspiration of, I was going to build a company. No, it was just something I enjoyed doing, it was fun. And I was making some money by the side for it, it was cool, and that was it. But there was no chests, really, even have chests.
Okay, I was going to ask you, like, were you scared to fail? But you've answered that in there, like, yes. Man, there was nothing to be scared of. But at what point did you realize, I have something here. Mm. And if I'm being extra, if I can take this thing and be extraordinary about it, yes, I will have something, mind-blowing. At what point did that...
So maybe 3 years or so, I had now after graduating from school, in short, before I graduated, I opened my first store, my first studio, and I opened it in Victoria Island, right? Which was a
studio was in Victoria Island.
Yes, which was a bold step.
Very bold. Very bold and very expensive.
Very bold, right? And in making the decision to start that store, as I continued to every day serve my customers, my brides, now more people were getting to know me. And at that time, there were no professional bridal makeup artists. Yes. So all the weddings called me, all the big weddings, really. But one of those days, I sat down and took records. At the end of the year, I did a calculation, and I had generated 9 million naira.
What year?
20 years ago. What year would that be?
2021. Yes. That's like 2001.
2001. Now, 9 million naira, I didn't even see the money. Like, I didn't know
you made that much.
Yes, that kind of money came through my hand. So I panicked, and I was like, 9 million naira, that's a lot of money. So the question was, how did I know that I had hit a jackpot, really? So I went to the bank, and I had a discipline of always banking all my transactions. Okay. So I knew that even if the paper was, I had an Apex Mill notebook. So Apex Mill was this, yes. I know. And I just take my Bible and just write.
Diary was the in thing.
Yeah. So at the end of the year, I did all the calculation. And I called my son, I said, calculate this money for me. She calculated it, the same amount. I was like, what? Hey. So I went to the bank. There was a small Union Homes and Savings Bank at Falomo Shopping. It was then called Falomo Shopping Center. It's no longer there. And I went to the bank to say to them, please, I want to, you guys should tell me how much came through this bank account that year. And they told me about 10 point something million. Ooh. I almost passed out. But at that moment, I realized that the numbers told me a story. And the story that the numbers was telling me was, this is a real business. It's not a joke anymore. And you need to take it even more seriously. That was that moment for me.
Let me read you this. In the country, locally and internationally, what are your favorite brands?
So internationally, my favorite brand is Mary Kay. Why? It's always been. Because of their ethos. So I'm a very purpose person, like I said earlier on. And I see a company that was built on purpose. And I saw a company that wanted to develop women. I admired her. I admired her so much that I went to visit her office. She's passed away now. I went to visit her office, sat at her desk, took pictures there. I've been totally, totally inspired by the ethos of that business and the values of that business and what they wanted to do for the world. Locally, there are many brands who have done exceptional stuff. From BM Pro, founded by Banke Meshida Lawal, who's just a great, phenomenal makeup artist. But then because of her skill, she's been able to create a product line to Zaron that come out maybe in the last 7 years, and they've done phenomenal in the last 7 years. But I really, really admire a very young beauty brand that's just been launched, I think maybe a year and a half ago, called Beauty by Didi. And her innovation, her packaging is very inspiring to see. So a lot of things have happened in the industry, and I'm very, very proud of the growth that we're experiencing as an industry.
Oh, okay. Now, there's the next goal for you personally and for your brand. Mm. I need to know, because you've achieved so much. Mm-hmm. So I want to be the first to hear some of the next firsts.
Okay. So we expanded into the continent, which is great. But we want you to be able to walk into Target, walk into Walmart, and see Tara in those stores.
What are for you personally? What are the things you've set aside as goals for yourself, for the rest of the year?
So my second son is going to university, which is a big deal, right? And I think my primary focus is getting the third one prepared. So my primary focus this year, personally, is my sons, just getting them into this new level, the new stage in their lives. Because, I mean, going into university, going to college is different. Leaving Nigeria to go to school is a totally different ballgame. And I need to prepare them spiritually. I need to prepare them from a heart standpoint. For my children to leave this country and know that in the 3 months, 5 months prior to them leaving, I was present, but not just present. I sowed some strong seeds in them that when they leave and there are issues, they can remember mommy's voice saying, you know, you are important to us. We cherish you, we love you, and we're going to support you regardless of what you experience.
And they remember the home of where you're coming
from. I won't say that.
You don't do that one?
No.
Run to your mind.
No, the pressure is too much. Pressure is too much. Nah. We love you and be
parenting. Be yourself.
And be the best that you can be. And this is what we tell our children all the time. You know, we don't put you under pressure to become number first in your class. We don't do that as a family, no. But the question was, what did you score? What was your average last term? And did you do better? That's what we want to hear.
Okay.
I'm not interested in you being first.
It's not a competition.
No, no, no. I don't even believe in competition, right? So I don't want you to be under pressure.
In a situation where there was no makeup, there was no beauty line, what will you be doing?
I'll be a missionary.
Missionary. Ooh. Okay, I didn't see that one coming.
It's
like, wow. I would not have guessed.
It was a buzz moment. Like, I saw the way you kind of...
Yeah, I'm like, missionary.
For makeup, missionary.
Like, missionary, okay, yes, okay. Yes, but like, yes. I see you love the life of service. Probably,
correct.
And your husband too. Was that something that attracted you to him?
Absolutely. Okay. Absolutely. That still makes me find him extremely attractive. Yes.
Now, one of my last questions. If you could call someone your role model or someone you looked up to or would like or love to be like, who would it be?
A better version of myself.
Self-love, guys. Self-love.
There are many people I admire that, you know, there are different things about them that I would like to
just
see. So Oprah Winfrey, her storytelling capacity, her impact. I think about Michelle Obama, her charm, her charisma, her eloquence. I think about Mrs. Awoshika, her doggedness on integrity as a Nigerian. I admire, I would like to emulate. Those are women. And of course, my husband, his heart of service, and his generosity. So if I add all those things together, then my better version of myself, I think I'll be fine.
So, woo! Ladies and gentlemen, you know what time it is? It is selfie time. Time for us to explore the greatness of the camera of the Phantom X.
Okay.
Hey! People are fine. You're beautiful. My mama is mommy T is beautiful. All right, let's do selfies. Hey.
Funny face.
Fresh. Okay. Lights are blinking again. It's game time.
Okay.
Kindly have a sit while I explain this to you.
Hmm.
We've heard juicy truths from Tara Durotoye. Now it's time for her to choose our dear. Are you ready?
Mm-mm.
So how this works, in these two phones, there's a dear. Whichever you choose, you have to perform the dear to the letter.
Hmm.
Kindly make your choice.
Why are you being so serious?
Are you sure?
Okay, I'm not.
Are you sure? Final choice?
Yeah.
Chose the other phone, you'd have had to act like your husband for the rest of the show. What your dear requires you to do is to wipe your makeup on set.
No!
I wanted to say just a straight face, it wasn't working. She's going to do it.
Yes.
You're going to do it.
I don't have a choice.
Okay, I like you. You're a person of your word. Okay, let's get to it. This should be interesting, guys.
Okay. Well, guys, at home, don't just use a wipe, right? To wipe off your makeup. Make sure you get some oil-based thing that you can put. Coconut oil will be good before you start to use wipes, right? I wouldn't advise to use wipes, if anything, because it may strip your skin too much. But we're going to use it for the sake of just to please Tobi and show him that I can take off my makeup.
Pew, pew, pew. But how long does it take to take off your makeup? Normally?
Maybe 30 minutes.
Ooh.
Depends on, so for example, if I've been on stage, for example, it means that the makeup will be different, it will be more.
Okay.
So that would take some time. But if it's like a regular, everyday makeup. Yeah, it's maybe 5 minutes or so.
Women try. 2 hours to put on the makeup, 30 minutes to take it off. No wonder you're always late. No wonder you take some more time getting ready.
Okay.
I wish I could help, but you know, the rules are the rules.
I'm a fine girl, don't worry. I'm not afraid of anything. My skin is
good. Natural skin, still popping.
Uh-huh.
That's how it should be. You take good care of your skin. What's your daily skincare routine?
So, Taking notes. I hear that.
Taking notes.
So I have a wash that is a combination of a wash and a toner.
Okay.
That I use. I usually spend about a minute trying to get that working. After that, then I use a scar repair because I had acne.
Okay.
In 2020, so I'm now having to repair that. I'm using a scar. And of course, I'm 44 now, so I've started to use Age Reversal lotions as well. And this period, sunscreen. With the sun.
Sunscreen.
If you're a guy, make sure you use a sunscreen. My boys are using sunscreen. My husband is using sunscreen
now. I'll start too. But it makes the face just look very oily.
No, it's not all. So get a lotion. You can get Tara as well.
Notes. I'm taking notes. I thought you were exaggerating when you said this thing takes time.
It does.
It's a lot of work. Looking beautiful, it's not children's business. So now when you see beautiful ladies on Instagram looking all glammed up, like the picture. Comment, say something nice. Like, I appreciate your work. I see the money you are spending. but you have good skin. You don't even need makeup.
Thank you. Well, you need makeup to be on TV. Otherwise.
Okay, yeah. You need that perfect look.
Yeah. You need makeup to be on TV.
Nice. So she did it. She did it. Let's give her a full round of applause.
Thank you.
And I appreciate the natural beauty too. Thank you very much. It's been nice having you on today's show.
Looking forward
to seeing you out there in public and then talking more and learning more from you.
With pleasure. Right. Thank you, Tobi.
I believe I'll see you again soon, Shana. Fingers crossed. Don't forget to join us next week. Here's a sneak peek of how it's going down. Ladies and gentlemen, make welcome Evelyn Akato.
I'm a professional now.
I'm the baby of the house. Let's move to you. I have an accent, so it was...
Yeah, I can hear your accent. Fine, but I've been here for you. Ladies and gentlemen, it is selfie time. It is time for us to gear our amazing athlete. That brings us to the end of today's show. Now, don't forget to stay tuned. But more importantly, stay bold, stay extraordinary.
Phantom X. New Elite flagship. Be bold. Be extraordinary.